this is the tutoring center. I'm the German tutor. Is that what you're here for? Yeah. It can be a difficult language to learn, but I guess all languages are that way, huh? Yeah. Have a seat. I can definitely help you with that. What's your name? Oh, it's very nice. Okay, well, I've heard that he's a very good teacher, so I think you're in good hands. How long have you been taking German? So that means that you're like 2 months in, is that right? Yeah, okay. Do you have an assignment that you're working on right now? Is it with you? Oh, great. Yeah, I'll take a look at it. That way I just kind of know where you're at and what I can do to help. Okay, great. Yeah, I'll take it. Let me see. I'll just look it over real quick and then we can get started. So you're just writing a little biography, kind of? Is that what the assignment is? Yeah, just to say what you like and what you do and who you are, kind of a thing. Yeah, it's a pretty common assignment for this level, I would say. And it's good to be able to talk about that stuff, right? Then you can make friends and to know people better. They can get to know you, of course. Yeah. Okay. Well, can you tell me what part of the language you're having the most problems with? Oh, yeah. That's tough. Yeah, I was there once. Yep, I remember what it's like to be a German student. Well, you're not the only one that has trouble with verbs. It's a pretty common complaint, I would say. Yeah. Well, I can just give you a good overview of how to use present tense in German. And then maybe we can go into some more detailed examples and you can take some notes. Does that sound good? Okay, good. I'll just get started then. Okay, so do you know any of the conjugations? Like for the ich form, the I form, do you know how to conjugate the verb? Oh, yeah. Sorry. Conjugate just means that you put the right ending on it. Or you have the form that matches the subject you're talking about. So, like, in English, if I say that I'm doing something, I'll say, like, I make, but he makes with an S. So that S or no S, that's the conjugation difference in English. So in German, yeah, you recognize that. It's hard to get to know the lingo of languages before... Yep, exactly. Okay, so for the ich form, yep, that's right. So it's the I, so you'd get ich mache, for I make, or I do. Yep, so what about the du form, which is the informal you? Du machst, genau, yeah, das ist richtig. For the er or sie form. You know these really well. Yeah. So it's the T. So er macht, sie macht, es macht. Yeah, sehr gut. Okay. Okay, so it must be more the when to use present tense and how it's used that's giving you trouble. You just have to get used to them. And you will. Okay. Well, so with present tense in German, there is quite a meaning difference and a usage difference between German and English. So when you do it in German, you just have your subject and then you have your verb conjugated. That's all you need. So in English, we have two different kinds of present tense that we use a lot. One of them means that you're doing something right now. So that's I am doing or I am going. He is watching. They are playing. That form uses some kind of to-be verb with it, but in German you don't need that at all, so we just get rid of it. That meaning in German is covered by the one where you just conjugate the verb. So you have ich mache, that can either mean I am doing or I am making, or it could also mean I do or I make, just in general, right? So if you say ich mache Hausaufgaben, I do homework, it could be the general one, or it could be that right now you're doing it. There's no way to tell except by context in German. Yeah, that's why. Yeah, but you'll figure it out. So just don't even use the extra verb. Okay. So that's what the meaning is. And then you have the conjugation down pretty good, I think. What about your irregular verbs? Maybe we should talk about those a little bit. Yeah, so sein and haben, those are the two most common. So those have very irregular forms. It's like in English, we have for our to-be verb, like sein, we have I am, he is, you are, and then, you know, they, we are. So is, am, and are somehow all the same verb, even though they look nothing alike. And they certainly don't look like the infinitive either, right? Be is, am, are. Makes no sense. But the reason that they're like that is because it's used so frequently. So there's this process in language that when a language is spoken a lot over time, it changes. And one of the forces that drives change is called leveling. And that just means that if you have one form that's kind of different, usually that change gets sort of evened out and everything becomes regular. For to be and other very, very high frequency words, that kind of leveling doesn't happen because they're used so often that they're sort of stuck where they are, so they don't change very much in a regular way. Yeah. Can really help you understand why things are the way they are. And usually that's so arbitrary in language, right? So it's good to have some kind of reason behind all the madness. Okay, so that's the explanation for why haben and sein are so just generally weird looking, right? So is sort of the more normal one. sign is the one like our to be. So you have ich bin, right? Do you remember the do form? Mm-hmm. Yeah, du bist. And the es form? Do you remember the RCS form? Yeah, that's right. So, ist. That one's the easiest, probably. Because it's so close to English. Mm-hmm. Yep. And then wir sind. Now here's the tricky one. What about ihr? The plural you. For informal. Oh, that one messes up everybody because you don't use it as often. It's ihr seid. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you can write it down. It's S-A-E-D seid. Yeah, mit D. Mm-hmm. Genau, gut. Okay. So, ich bin, du bist, sie oder es ist, wir sind, ihr seid und sie sind. Yeah, so that's either the plural, they, sie sind, or if you write it with a capital letter, then it's sie formal. You singular or plural, but it's formal, so. Mm-hmm. Well, the difference is that when you use Z, usually you're talking to someone who is either like older than you, or like it could be your boss at work, or maybe just a stranger. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but do you're gonna use with your peers. Classmates, other students, you would always use do with. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you can call me do. Yeah, tut's mich. Mm-hmm. Okay. So that's the verb sein, which is the craziest one. So you don't like it's all downhill from sein because they're all gonna be easier than that. So haben is the other most frequent irregular verb in German. And some of it sort of looks normal, right? So the ich form. Do you remember how to do that one? Yeah, genau. So this is ich habe, because it looks just normal. You just have the e at the end, like you would with an irregular verb. Yeah, but it gets pretty tricky starting at the next one. Okay, so du. Yeah, du hast. So no B in that one. And there's no B in the next one either. So oder sie hat. And then wir. Yeah, haben. Gut. Und ihr. Try again. Oh, so close. Ihr habt with the B. Yeah. Yep. Usually the plurals look a lot more regular than the ich and the du and the er form. Yeah. So that one looks as if it were normal, basically. And then sie haben. Yeah. Good. Okay. So. You've got haben and sein. You did pretty good with the conjugations of the regular verbs. Do you want to go over any other verbs? Yeah, okay. Yeah, the modal verbs are also irregular. Mm-hmm. So müssen is a modal verb. The modal thing just means that it's not telling you like an action. It's telling you about the subject's relationship to some other verb, like the action of some other verb. So with müssen, for example, it's telling you what you must do, what you have to do, right? Yeah. So those, they all have their conjugations, and you basically just have to memorize those. Yeah, I see. You've got your chart there. That's good. Yeah, when you're writing, especially, it's good to have that handy so that you can look at it, and then you get the right form to write down. Yeah, okay. Well, do you understand how the modals work when you have another verb involved? Yeah, so it's the infinitive form that you want to use with it, which always ends in an N. Usually it's E-N. So like machen, spielen, gehen, tanzen, whatever you have there. So how would you say I have to do my homework? Do you know that one? So ich muss, yeah, that's a good start. Hausaufgaben, that's homework. Gibt's so, yeah, ich muss meine Hausaufgaben, and then your verb goes at the end. So ich muss meine Hausaufgaben machen. Yeah, you can write. So that one is at the end because the modal verb is the one that's in the second position. So normally you always have a verb in second, right? And here you do too. It's just that it's a modal verb. And so when you have another one on top of that, it goes to the end. I think that you probably do have enough information that you can fix your paper, and if you have any questions, of course you can come on back to see me. Yeah, I'm here most days in the afternoons. Okay, well, it was so nice to meet you, and good luck on your German learning adventure.